What is up, guys, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be doing the fourth episode of my series called Becoming a Homeowner. And in today's episode, we are going to be talking all about finding our home, making an offer on it, and what happens after that. If you've not been following along with this series, I will leave a link to the full series down below so that you can catch up. So once we got pre-approved, we found our realtor, we started house hunting, now we found our home, now the hunt is finally over. Right before we found our house, we went through probably a 5-week dry spell where we were literally just not finding anything. And mind you, my husband and I each had like 7 apps on our phones, maybe even more, that we would check religiously every morning, every noon, every night. We would check multiple times a day looking for a house. We just weren't finding anything. And the longer you look for homes, I feel like the more picky you get because you start to know what to look for and what not to look for. And especially by looking at the outside style of the home, you have a pretty good idea of what the layout is going to look like on the inside. So at this point, I was honestly starting to just lose hope because winter is coming, winter was around the corner, and I did not want to move in the middle of winter. So I was really starting to get worried. And honestly, this is such a big, huge purchase in your life. This is such a big stepping stone that even though we were super eager to find our home, we were definitely willing to be patient until we found the one because we did not want to just jump into anything. So I vividly remember this day. I was at work and I was just talking to my friends at work and honestly just feeling super defeated. My lunch break comes and I text my realtor and I start sending her homes over what we wanted to pay. Because I was honestly like, maybe we should just increase what we want to spend and, you know, maybe we'll find our dream home faster if we just increase, you know, our personal budget. And right after I sent her that, I kid you not, I open up one of the apps, I refresh the page, and our house pops up. And I was like, oh my gosh, you have got to be kidding me. Like, from first glance, I was like, I love this house. It's so different. It's so unique. I love it. And I'm going through, I'm looking through everything on the inside, and I'm like, wow, this is insane. What perfect timing. Boom, there it is. The style, the location, the landscaping, the yard, the garage, all the updates, the kitchen. It was so perfect. Mind you, it was a lot cheaper than we wanted to spend, and it was a little bit smaller than we wanted it to be, but overall, it was crossing off every single check mark on our list. I immediately have her disregard everything I just sent her, and I sent her the link to this house and we go and we look at it. I think it was the next day. I remember pulling up to her house and I remember just sitting outside and saying how much I loved the house. We go inside. I kept saying how much I loved it and how like obsessed I was becoming with it and how much potential I saw in it to make this house our actual home. So once we finish looking at it, we sit there and we're weighing the pros and cons, and the pros are far outweighing the cons, and they're all things that we are able to overlook or slightly adjust in the future to make it perfect for us. So we decided that we for sure wanted to put in an offer. And whenever you put in an offer on a house, you have a lot of things that you have to decide and factor in. So putting in an offer on a house, you have to decide, of course, how much you want to offer the seller. You have to decide if you want to ask for seller's assist, and if so, how much are you going to ask for? You have to decide which loan you're going to go with, which will also highly influence how much you're going to put down. You're going to have to decide what you want to come with the house, you know, decide on all those contingencies. You have to specify exactly what you want to be inspected. You have to have your deposit amount. You have to pick a ideal closing date, etc. There's a lot of little things that you have to decide on whenever you are putting in your offer, which our realtor was amazing and super helpful, so it wasn't a very stressful process. So we personally just didn't want to mess around. The house was just put on the market. There were already people looking at it. We actually came back to look at it a second time, and another family was looking at it at the same time we were, and we were like, no, let's just give them what they want. Let's give them a really good offer and make sure we do not miss out on this house. So we put our offer in and we heard back, I think it was the next day, but waiting to hear back from the sellers was super nerve-wracking because you have no idea what they're gonna say, if they're going to accept it or deny it or want to negotiate something with you. Luckily, they accept our offer. Yay, super exciting. But now the stress really starts to come. And with that starts all of the paperwork that you have to do. That whole first week after we got our offer accepted was crazy. Going back and forth, sending out documents. If you have been watching my series, you saw my pre-approval video that once you get pre-approved, it's only good for 60 to 90 days. Well, we went over that mark, so we had to send in all of our documents again, and they had to pull our credit for a second time. And while this is all happening, you have to make sure that you get everything sent to them as soon as possible because you do not want to miss your closing date. If you miss your closing date, you run the risk of having to pay extra fees and forking out even more money. Nah, I'm good, sis. I wanted to make that closing date because I didn't want to spend any more money than we already were having to spend. So that was the start of the stress. It was all fun and games until it started to get really, really real. It was freaking happening and it didn't even feel real because we wanted this to happen for like 6 months and it felt like it was just never going to happen, but it did. So my big advice to you is just to be patient. Like I said, this is a huge, 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 huge purchase and it's such a big decision for your life, whether this is a house that you're gonna stay in for a couple of years or whether you're gonna be here for the rest of your life. Regardless, this is a load of money that you're spending and you don't wanna be stuck with something that you absolutely hate just because you wanted to get the process over with. So now that that was set, we found our house, we put our offer in, offer was accepted, we got all of our paperwork sent in. Now it was time to start the home inspection, the appraisal, getting the homeowner's insurance, getting all the utilities switched, all of that fun stuff, and that is exactly what I'm gonna be talking about in the next episode for this series. I really hope that this was helpful and informative for you guys. If you have any other suggestions or tips that you wanna share about this topic, make sure you leave them in the comment section down below for anyone else who may be watching. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure you let me know by hitting the thumbs up button. If you haven't already subscribed, what are you doing? Make sure you hit that red subscribe button so that you don't miss any of my videos. And as always, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.